CenterNet is a milestone in anchor-free object detection. Some of the recent state-of-the-art anchorless object detectors are based on it. So, it's important to understand the fundamentals of CenterNet. Hey there, welcome to LearnOpenCV. In this video, we'll understand how CenterNet works, its loss functions, and compare its various backbones. CenterNet represents an object as a point called a key point. This is the bounding box center. The model takes an input image of width W and height H and outputs a prediction of width floor W by R and height floor H by R. Here, R is the model output stride. It has three heads, the key point heat map, local offset, and object size. The heat map values are assigned using an exponential distance. It means at the object center, the heat map value is 1, and it decreases exponentially as it moves further away from the object center. There are C channels of the heat map, where C is the number of object classes. During heat map calculation, due to the output stride and the floor operation, multiple pixels from the input image map to the same pixel on the output heat map. For example, point 200-200 and point 203-203 on the input image will both map to the point 50-50 on the heat map for output stride 4. Now, to get the final predictions, we have to scale up the heat map back to the original image dimension and map the values to the input image. But the scale-up operation may lead to a precision errors up to R-1 pixel. In this case, errors up to 3 pixels. Local offset prediction fixes this error. It has a depth of 2 to fix both the X and Y coordinate offset. Object size predicts the width and the height of the bounding box. It has a depth of 2 as well. This is the heat map loss equation. Here, N is the number of bounding boxes. Hence, the heat map loss is averaged over the number of bounding boxes. The equation is made of two parts. The loss function acts as focal loss at the bounding box center. However, the equation becomes interesting for the other case. Let's further divide the equation into two. The latter part is focal loss for the negative class. We can skip it. The former part, however, acts as a discounting factor. It discounts more if the heat map is closer to the key point. The offset loss equation and the size loss equation are both mean absolute error equations. CenterNet models come with three different backbones. Hourglass-104 is used without modification. ResNet-101 is upsampled using transpose convolution and uses deformable convolutions to change the number of channels before upsampling. A modified DLA is also used. It has more skip connections, and the convolution layers are replaced with deformable convolution layers for regular upsampling. Since CenterNet detects objects as points, it can also be extended to detect key points of objects. It treats these key points as classes and generates heat maps for each class. Let's assume we want to predict K key points. If there's only one person in the image, combining heat map and offset will have the precise location of all the key points of a single person. The problem arises when there is more than one person. Even if you have the precise location of all the key points, it is difficult to determine which key point belonged to whom. Joint location prediction is crucial in solving the problem. It predicts the location of all the key points for the corresponding object center. However, it is less accurate than the heat map plus offset prediction. Hence, joint location is used to map joint heat map plus offset to its corresponding object center. Comparing the latency and the MAP plot, CenterNet performs better than YOLO V3, faster RCNN, and RetinaNet. Comparing the Hourglass and ResNet backbone, we discover Hourglass performs better. In this image, Hourglass is able to detect the bench, but ResNet cannot. Meanwhile, in this image, Hourglass can detect the sports ball, yet ResNet cannot. So, that's all about CenterNet. Head on to our playlist section to find a dedicated playlist on object detection. Like and subscribe for more such videos. Until next time, thank you.